if we want to limit community transmission, we've got to decide what we're going to, you know, what we're going to contribute to community transmission and how we're going to prevent it getting too high. So the way that, you know, you can think of it is like you have a budget. You've got a certain amount of transmission that you are happy to allow. And if it adds up to being too much, then you're going to start getting a growing outbreak, or it's going to end up becoming potentially overwhelming. You can decide how much you want to allow. It might be none at all. You might want to be New Zealand, or you might want to be South Korea, or you might want to keep it sort of going along at a point where it just infects people slowly and steadily and you don't get a very large surge. Once you've decided that, you've got to decide what's most important. Now, schools are one of the most important parts of our society. Not only do they educate kids, they feed lots of them. Some children are safer in school than they are at home. And, you know, closing schools particularly hits the vulnerable. It's also very true that for working parents, and we are in that category, school closures makes it very much more difficult to be doing your job. And because you have to be working from home potentially, and you also have to be, you know, homeschooling. That's what I spent the first few hours this morning doing. So there's every reason to think that schools should be a priority. But once you open them, you run the risk of that contributing to community transmission. And that aside, if you have a point when community transmission is so high that you're going to have to be going back in the direction of, you know, more severe restrictions, then schools may close anyway. So I think what we need to do is not open until we're really at the limit of another outbreak, and then in a few months add schools again on top of that. I think we should be building, you know, schools into our plan. That means prioritizing different parts of our society and the economy. And it's really difficult to make those decisions. I accept that, and I don't want to say that I have all the answers. I really don't. However, I do think that's a much more useful way to think about it.